Hello. I'm wondering how many amongst you recognize me with all of this professional gear on me here. I'm Norbert Gleich, MD, and I am the medical director and chief scientist here at CHR. And you see me in this outfit because this is how we live at CHR currently during the healthcare crisis that obviously affects CHR like everybody else here in this country and worldwide. The COVID-19 virus has completely changed our lives. We cannot deny that, and I think everybody, particularly in larger cities, has been experiencing radical, I would have to say, unprecedented changes to how we are used to live and to conduct our professions and our social lives. And closing down normal life also involved closing down many medical offices. And though there has been a discussion within the field of infertility, whether fertility center should be closing down or not, that discussion really got additional impetus from a recent position statement published by our principal professional organization, the American Society for Reproductive Medicine, or ASRM, which was interpreted by many of our colleagues as meaning that they should shut down the centers and stop all treatment activities. This is not how we here at CHR interpreted that opinion. And this is important to note. Indeed, our interpretation of the SRM opinion was that it was a very carefully balanced opinion which made a lot of sense. In other words, it was very logical and at the same time very professional. What our interpretation of the ASRM opinion has been from the very beginning is that the ASRM rightly says that there are in principle two kinds of fertility treatments. There are fertility treatments which can safely be delayed, meaning fertility treatments where there is no harm to the patient from waiting a few months and having the same treatments a few months later. Indeed, we here at CHR would argue that that is the vast majority of fertility treatments. The vast majority of fertility treatments fall into this category. If you're a young woman who needs an IVF cycle or who needs an insemination cycle, whether you have your first cycle next week or in 3 months, very likely makes absolutely no difference. We feel that it is correct to recommend that these kind of services be delayed. And we feel that it is correct because it serves the benefit of the patient who is exposed to risks if she has to leave her home and has to come to a center like ours. It serves the benefit of our employees at our fertility center because the less they are exposed to patients coming in, the lower their risk. And ultimately, it also serves the general good because it reduces the general risk. And if you're listening to what the experts have been telling us in that regard, everybody counts, because everybody who prevents himself or herself from getting sick saves many other individuals downstream who may get contaminated from each one of us. So in summary, we here at CHR indeed believe that a large majority of fertility treatments characterized as non-urgent can be safely delayed by 3 to 4 months, and we believe that the ASRM was absolutely correct in suggesting that these kind of treatments, in everybody's interest, indeed be delayed. This doesn't mean that the ASRM stated that every fertility center should close doors. This also does not mean that the ASRM stated that urgent cases, and those are cases where 3 or 4 months do make a difference in the potential of being successful with fertility treatment. ASRM never said that those cases should not be handled. Indeed, in one of the main points in the ASRM statement, there's a distinct exception for urgent cases. And this raises, of course, the question, what is an urgent case? And I think that's where the big misunderstanding has been happening and where the conflict exists between colleagues who are attacking the ASRM statement and those who are defending it. The issue is that urgency means that a woman, a patient, a couple would be exposed to adverse outcome effects if they did not get speedy treatment. That concept exists in medicine in every field. And if there was a mistake that the ASRM made in the announcement was that they did not go into more detail in explaining this point. We here at CHR understood the ASRM position statement the following way. We basically believe that what the ASRM has been telling us is that what's urgent is urgent, and what's not urgent is not urgent. Now, most IVF centers don't do much urgent fertility care, because most IVF centers, as we all know from national statistics, if a woman reaches age 42 or 43, automatically refer them into egg donation. But there are centers like CHR, not many, but there are some, who treat older women. And if you're treating a 45-year-old or a 46-year-old woman, 3 months or 4 months can make one hell of a difference. So in other words, individual centers need to think where they stand in that range of providing services. If you are a center that has a lot of older patients, or even younger patients, but with very low ovarian reserve, and if you are practicing in a way where you are still trying to help these women to conceive with their own eggs rather than ship them off into egg donation, then you have an obligation to consider what delays of 3, 4, 5 months may mean for those patients. And if you serve these patients, then just closing your store and saying, okay, call me when everything is over, is really, in our opinion at least, not the right approach. Nor do we believe that this was ASRM's intent in making their statement. So We here at CHR, as a center of last resort, decided to stay open for exactly those reasons. The average age of IVF patients in the US over the last few years has been pretty steady at around age 36. At CHR, it's 43. This means that half of CHR's patients are actually older than 43. I think everybody who listens to me now will understand that a center that has half of their patients above age 43 has different responsibilities towards their patients than a center with an average age of 36. It's as simple as that. And I think it's as simple as that to understand the ASRM guidelines, and therefore we here at CHR are open, and many of our colleagues rightly closed their offices. I hope that explains a little bit about the conflict that has been going on between different groups of colleagues on the subject. If you have any further questions, you know where to reach us. Thank you very much.